Hi, I'm Carly McAvoy. I'm talking about multiplying whole numbers today. There are many ways to write a multiplication problem. All of the following are asking us to multiply 5 by 7. And you can see that when we used to write it, we'd always use the X here. We can also put a dot, or we can use parentheses either around one number or both numbers. It could be around the first number or the second number. We could even put parentheses and a dot. That's a little redundant. Same thing with this. We can put parentheses around it with the multiplication sign in the middle. Those all say 5 times 7. The goal is to be as efficient as possible. X is often used in algebra as a variable, so we tend to stop using it as a sign of multiplication except in specific instances in algebra. So if I was going to write 5 times 7, I would probably write this one most of the time because it's the easiest way, just with one dot in the middle. Two important things to remember: the zero property of multiplication says if you multiply a number by zero, you always get zero. Zero times 15 is zero. 3,782 times zero is zero. It doesn't matter if the zero comes first or second. If one of your factors, that's part of your multiplication problem, is zero, then the whole thing is zero. And remember, the answer to a multiplication problem is product. We saw that in another video. But the two things you're multiplying are factors, and the answer is a product. The second thing I wanted to remind you about was the multiplicative identity, which is one. And what that means is that if you multiply any number by one, your answer will be the original number. For instance, 1 times 18 is 18. 89 times 1 is 89. So multiplying by 1 doesn't change the original number. And we use that for many different things in math. We use that concept. So it's an important thing to remember. If I had a very long number or working with multiple digits, such as 217 times 315, I would probably write them in parentheses rather than just a dot in the middle because it's easy to get lost when you have a lot of numbers. So it's okay to write them that way too. And for multiplication without a calculator, we usually do that by writing them vertically, like we can see here. And I'm going to go through a couple of examples of multiplication. Again, this may be something that you don't need. You can fast forward if you need to, or you can watch it if you don't quite remember. The way I'm going to do it, 7 times 5 is 35. We put the 5 and carry the 3. 3 times 7 is 21, plus 3 more is 24. Carry the 2. 2 times 7 is 14, plus 2 is 16. And then I'm going to put a 0 before I start my second number. 1 times 5 is 5. 1 times 3 is 3, and 1 times 2 is 2. And finally, I just add straight down 5, 9, 9, 3. 3,995 is my final answer. What about when I'm multiplying by 100? When you multiply by 100, all you have to do is add the two zeros to the end. This is going to be 3, 7, 5, 1, the original number, with two more zeros on the end. It makes it really easy to do. If I have 30, let's say I have 375 times 1,000, then I would take the 375 and I would add three zeros. Anytime you multiply by a power of 10, and by a power of 10 we mean 10, 100, 1,000, 10,000, anytime you multiply by something like that, you just keep the number the same and then you add those number of zeros to the end. So that's a nice shortcut. And if we have 200, well, really all we have to do is double the number and then add the two zeros. So we would just say 23 times 2 is 46 and then add your two numbers. But you can also write that out. You can do it this way. You can put your zeros kind of over to the side and just bring them straight down. 2 times 3 is 6, and 2 times 2 is 4. That's another way to do that without having to write out rows and rows of zeros. All right, one more. 3 times 8 is 24. Carry the 2. 6 times 8 is 48, plus 2 is 50. 4 times 8 is 32, plus 5 is 37. Notice I have a 0 here. I could write a row of zeros, but instead I'm just going to put two zeros and then go ahead and do this number. So 1 times 3 is 3, 1 times 6, and 1 times 4. And then I'm going to add that together, 4, 0, 10, 10, and 5, 50,004. Always, in for my purposes, you can see what your own instructor says, but you can always go and try that on the calculator to practice 463 times 108. To check it, I mean, is 50,004. So you can always go and check that with a calculator, but you should also be able to do it without a calculator and be able to show your work. Sometimes you see things like this, 8 and then parentheses, 5 plus 2, and it might say distribute to simplify, and we're going to talk about order of operations in a later video, but two things you could do here. One is inside the parentheses, you could add those two things together. 15 plus 2 is 17. And then once you do that, you can see, oh, this is one of the ways we said we could write multiplication. That just says 8 times 17. And we could do that out with a calculator, or you can do it by hand. 17 times 8 is 136. Notice that 8 times 17 is also 136. So it doesn't matter what order you put those into your calculator when you're multiplying. It certainly would matter if you were doing division or subtraction. Anyway, we could also do this. We could take 8 times 15 plus 8 times 2. That's another way to think about that. What this is saying is the 8's on the outside, it's going to multiply times the 15, and it's going to multiply times the 2. Well, 8 times 15 is 120, and 8 times 2 is 16. What is 120 plus 16? It's 136. So either way, you're going to get the same answer. And finally, we practice multiplication by asking you to find the area of a shape. So let's look at this shape right here. And the area formula is just length times width. So if I wanted you to find the area of the entire big rectangle, I would say that's going to be 5 times 8. And 5 times 8 is 40, and we're going to talk about that as centimeters squared. This is the big one. What about the little one? Well, the little one is 4 times 3. And that's 12 centimeters squared. So this asks us to find the area of the shaded portion. It's not the big, it's not the little piece that we just found, but everything outside that. All you do in that case is subtract the little one from the big one. So 40 minus 12 is 28. That would be the area of the shaded part. So just find the area of the big rectangle and subtract the little one, and that leaves the shaded area in left behind. And then what if I asked you to find the perimeter? Because we're going to talk about that later on in Chapter 8, but sometimes you remember that from before. A perimeter is not multiplication, and a perimeter is addition. And so to find the perimeter, you would just do 8 plus 5 plus 8 plus 5. And there's one of those that they just kind of slide in sometimes, that they start asking you things that we haven't really talked about yet. But anyway, that would be 26. 10, 26, yeah. And that would be centimeters. Okay, have a fantastic day. We'll talk to you next time.